Hello, this is RetroTK2, and today you'll learn about SSH keys with Git. You'll learn what they are, how to generate one within SourceTree, and how you can use it. If you're new to the channel, or if you haven't already checked out my other version control videos, you definitely should. The card to the playlist should be on your screen now. I was requested to make this video by George. I hope it helps you, lad. So let's get started. Well, what is an SSH key? According to Wikipedia, Secure Shell, SSH, is a cryptographic network protocol for operating network services securely over an unsecure network. SSH provides a secure channel over an unsecure network in a client-server architecture, connecting an SSH client application with an SSH server. SSH uses public key cryptography to authenticate the remote computer and allow it to authenticate the user, if necessary. There are several ways to use SSH. One is to automatically generate public-private key pairs to simply encrypt a network connection, and then use a password authentication to log on. The public key is placed on all computers that must allow access to the owner of the matching private key. The owner keeps the private key secret. While authentication is based on the private key, the key itself is never transferred through the network during authentication. Phew. Alright. That's what SSH and an SSH key is, but why do you want one? Well, according to Atlassian's help documentation, because you don't have an SSH setup, you've been using the Secure Hypertext Transfer Protocol, HTTPS, to communicate between your local system and Bitbucket Cloud, or GitHub or GitLab, depending on which host you're using. When you use HTTPS, you authenticate, supply a username and password, each time you take an action that requires a connection with Bitbucket. That'll be your pushes and your pulls. Who wants to do that? Yeah, who does want to do that? Put simply, doing this means you won't have to keep logging in with your credentials every time you want to communicate with your remote repo. Hang on a second, I don't think I've ever had to retype my credentials in after the initial push I made with SourceTree. That's because SourceTree kindly caches your credentials, making this statement somewhat inapplicable to us. So once again, I ask, should you use SSH over HTTPS? Well, I couldn't get a definite answer in this one. According to one Stack Overflow user on a question about why does GitHub recommend HTTPS over SSH? HTTPS is recommended by GitHub because it is a port that is open in all firewalls. SSH is not always open as a port for communication on a network and is often blocked by network firewalls. A GitHub repository is therefore more universally accessible using HTTPS than SSH. SSH keys are more secure in that they do not provide access to your GitHub account, although if somebody does get a hold of your private key, they can do a forced push of an empty repository and wipe out your change history. My preference is to use SSH with the passphrase protected key. I would advise a bit more reading on the subject if you're still unsure what to use. I usually use HTTPS just to get an account up and running, then when I get the time to set up an SSH key for my computer, I use that instead. Really, it is completely up to you. I must admit, I hate setting up SSH keys and keeping track of all my private keys, but once it's up and running, it's usually grand. Right, now all that explanation is out of the way, let's get this show on the road. First, let me show you what happens when you try and clone a repository using the SSH URL without a key setup. For this, I'll be using the Channel Files repository. Feel free to clone it yourself. Card should be on your screen now. When you get to the page, click the drop-down with the HTTPS in it and select SSH. Then click the icon beside the text field to copy the URL to your clipboard. Open SourceTree. Click the Clone New icon in the top left corner. Make sure the Clone Repository tab is selected. And paste the URL into the source path URL text field. Now select the destination's path text field and let the repository type field check the source. Here we get a warning saying authentication via SSH keys field. Do you want to launch the SSH key agent, pageant, and retry? If you don't have an SSH key yet, you can create one or import it using the menu option, Tools, Create or Import SSH Keys. This is exactly what we're going to do. Let's create our SSH key. Click No, click cancel, and then click cancel. Click tools, create or import SSH keys. If you don't see this in the tools menu, yes, it might be because you don't have your SSH client set to PuTTY PLINK. To set it to PuTTY, click tools, options. When the dialog pops up, click the general tab and then click the drop down beside SSH client. Select PuTTY. You're also going to want to make sure the checkbox beside automatically start SSH agent when source tree opens is checked. Doing this means you won't have to start it each time you open SourceTree. Click OK. Now we can try it again, yes. Click Tools, Create or Import SSH Keys. The PuTTY Key Generator dialog should open. Click Generate. A progress bar should appear asking you to move your mouse around. The program uses your mouse coordinates to generate the key, so make sure you go a little bit crazy to ensure maximum randomness, yes. Also, make sure you're moving the mouse inside the dialog, otherwise it won't progress. With any luck, your key should generate. You can create as many keys as you like, you just have to make sure you link them correctly. You may want to give your SSH key a passphrase as well, yes? A passphrase is basically a password and will need to be typed in anytime you want to carry out a GET action, such as a push or a pull. For that reason, I usually keep it blank, yes, but feel free to add one if you like. To do so, type the passphrase you want into the key passphrase text field and retype it again into the confirm passphrase text field. Now we need to save our private key. Click Save Private Key. If you're like me and haven't typed in the passphrase, you'll get a warning like this is. Click Yes to continue. Select a location and a meaningful name and click Save. Make sure you keep this key in a safe place. If you lose the private key, you'll have to generate a completely new SSH key. You've now generated your SSH key, yes. Now we need to add the private key to our PuTTY agent and add our public key to our Git hosts account. Let's set up the private key first. Click the arrow in the bottom right of the taskbar to bring up the quick launch icons. You should see one with a computer and a black hat. If you're still unsure, yes, hover the mouse over it and it should display the text P-Agent PuTTY Authentication Agent. If you don't see the PuTTY icon, it could be because the icon hasn't been launched. To launch it, head back into SourceTree and click Tools Launch SSH Agent. Right-click on the PuTTY icon and click Add Key. Navigate to your private key's location, select it and click Open. Just to make sure it's definitely added, yes, right-click on the PuTTY icon and click View Keys. You should see your key in the list all ready to go. That should be it for the private key, yes. Now all we need to do is set up the public key. To do that, head over to your Git hosting site and log in using your account. For this video, I'm going to use GitLab, but the setup should be pretty similar with any other hosting site. Once you've signed in, navigate to your profile settings page. For GitLab, you can get there by clicking your avatar in the top right corner and clicking Settings. Click SSH Keys and you should be ready to set it up. Once again, if you're using a different Git host, this part will be a little bit different. But so long as you get to the SSH Keys section, it should be pretty similar after that. Now we have to paste our public key into the text field beside Key. Head back into SourceTree. If, like me, you've closed your PuTTY Key Generator dialog, click Tools, Create or Import SSH Keys. Once it pops up, click Field, Load Private Key, and select the private key you saved earlier. Click Open. Now click on the text area below the text Public Key for passing into OpenSSH Authorized Underscore Keys file. My goodness. Select the whole key, yes, and press Ctrl-C to copy it. Head back to your profile settings page and paste the key into the text field under the text key. You'll want to give this key a meaningful title, yes. Usually I set up an SSH key for each computer I use, so my title is usually the location of my computer, but feel free to choose whatever one you like. Once that's all done, click Add Key. You can now execute Git commands on your remote repository using the SSH protocol. To see if it's working, try cloning the channel files using the same method we used before. If all goes well, the channel files should clone correctly. And that's it. Rate, comment and subscribe, yes, I hope you're well. You can email me at retrotk2@gmail.com with any requests you have for future videos. Once again, I'd like to thank George for this video idea. Feel free to suggest another one anytime. Thank you for watching this, and I'll see you in the next video.